So just tell us what you're doing here, Edward.
Just putting this rock here.
Okay, so is that going to fit in alright?
Yeah, I think it is. If you get a drill, drill it into the
pit. Yeah, okay.
Oh, we're doing here, we're just, so the fish don't jump out and get beached, we're just raising this wall up a bit.
The side wall has now been raised up by, well, a good 10-12 inches in most places, which will hopefully stop the water spilling over the far side and we get a spate. So this is the first decent bit of rain we've actually had since probably, I would say, March, and it's now late July. And it's the first lift that we've had in the Beck, and looks like we've timed our work party to perfection because we've only just got these stone baffles in here last week. And you can see it's concentrated the flow down nicely. And all that remains is for this area here, on this side of the metalwork, to be baffled, so that we can do something about the flow. And looking on the far side there, compared to how it used to be, which was just used to be a straight rushing flume that came down unbroken, you can actually see that we've now got areas of water which have basically been slowed down with high pressure waves just in front of them, low pressure waves just behind the baffles. Looking through, you can just see the edges of some of the baffles sticking up above the water there. But on the far bank, with the retaining wall heightened, there's a good case in point right over there, where before we put the heightening pieces on it, that water would have been running over the side. We've obviously stopped that from happening now. If you look at the standing waves that the baffles have created, hopefully there's enough area in front of each baffle that a fish could rest up on its way up the ladder. You see, that's all the way up to the top. And that baffle at the top of the metalwork there has done something about the flow of water going into the top of these baffles. It makes it look a little bit more amenable for the fish, I would say. Of course, that's just my opinion. I don't know what the fish will think of it. And then right here on the last section of baffle, you can just see halfway down that box section, there is a baffling piece which has broken the flow up, and yet we've managed to open up the bottom in order to create an attractor flow into that metal ladder. And that looks very, very different just downstream of the original arrangement, which had it just running like a little jet of water. It now looks like there's an area right in here, which is a nice slack water piece of slack water where fish, hopefully once they're up the top of the waterfall, can actually rest in that section. I think some more baffles are needed down on this main part of where the water comes down. Certainly looking at the flow running down there now, you can see a load of small standing waves, which is in total contrast to the previous setup where it was just a straight run. One of the issues that the Tees River Trust are working on are the effects of siltation runoff into water in the Tees catchment area. The case in point here, you can actually quite clearly see that where this beck is running down and meeting the main water of the Leven, the colour contrast is quite a lot. The water out of the beck is obviously picking a lot of silt up on the way down. And I know that Ben Lamb from the Tees River Trust has identified that as one of his main focus points for clearing this spot up.